Set your alarms. Late tonight, a total eclipse will turn the moon red.
The moon's surface will slowly start to darken late in the evening into tomorrow morning. Astronomer Joe joins us with how you can catch a glimpse. We love that you're here today.
Hello, what a delight to be back here.
Oh my goodness, because we need help. We want to make sure that we maximize our views and have what we need in order to view this.
Oh yeah, I'm here to share with you.
Yeah, so tell us, what is actually happening with this lunar eclipse?
Things are getting in the way of other things celestially. The Earth is getting in the way of the sun and casting its shadow onto the face of the moon. And that's a total lunar eclipse. The moon is passing by the shadow and staying there for a little bit and then on its way as it orbits our planet. And this happens 2 times a year on the average, and 2 solar eclipses a year on the average. And we're lucky enough to be in the proper position to see this lunar eclipse. All the Americas will get a front row seat for this.
Because the next one we won't, correct?
Well, the next one will be till next year in March.
Next year in March we'll get it, okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, how does it turn red?
Because
we're hearing about this blood moon aspect of it. So when this is all happening, what scientifically is making it look red to us?
Now, of course, the moon does not change color
right.
at all. Totally an illusion.
Wait, but... what? Minds are blown.
I hate to blow the bubble, but
yeah. Okay.
It's the atmosphere of the planet Earth. It acts as a prism, and it refracts the light. The blue light is very energetic, and it doesn't like to be bothered or disturbed. The longer red waves punch through everything, and that's what allows the moon to become reddish copperish.
I love that. We've got that little visual up there for you right now, so you can see what Joe's talking about. And unlike the solar eclipse, this is something that we don't need special gear, see.
Perfectly safe, naked eye observation.
Okay.
From beginning to end, and it's a 5-hour event.
Yay. So do I have to stay up for all of it? Because this is in the middle of the night. We're talking 11:30, Joe. I've got 2 kids.
It is.
What time should I wake up to get the best of the best and then go back to bed?
It starts at midnight.
Okay.
Maximums at 2 a.m.
2 a.m. Central Time, okay.
And it's over at 5.
Okay. All
so right. If you start about 1:30, 2 o'clock, you've seen it.
You've seen it.
Yeah. All right. You want me to text you tonight at around 1:30?
I do.
Call you?
I love it. Okay. Last time when we had the Northern Lights up, I tried to wake up my whole family, and they're like, if you can see it with the naked eye, wake us up.
Oh.
Yeah.
Because you had to only see it through your phone at the time. Uh-huh, but this, you're saying, is something that we're going to be able to just see.
Yeah. It'll be pretty high up, 50 degrees high up. And for those, you use your fist, 5 fists up on the horizon, 50 degrees.
Okay.
And
that's
how the ancients measured the skies.
Incredible.
And it'll be up good enough, naked eye, but binoculars will enhance the event.
Okay.
And you have a telescope, a modest one like this one.
That is not modest, Joe.
No, that is not.
This is just a small one.
In your backyard. Okay. That's beautiful. So when you're watching on something like that, I mean, goodness gracious.
Oh, it fills the eyepiece.
Yeah.
And you are part of the event.
And what's great about what you do is that kids from across Chicago, not this time because it's in the middle of the night, but anytime we have other events, you go out on the 606 Trail with After School Matters, with the Park District, and they are allowed the opportunity to view something like that.
And sometimes it's the first opportunity they have to look through a telescope. And then after hours, this is good to rest a martini right on top of it.
Referencing our previous martini segment.
First St. Patrick's Day.
But here's the thing. Where are you going to be exactly? Because, I mean, not that I'm going to show up or anything, but I just mean in terms of should you be on top of a roof? Should you be where?
To
be able to...
It's a misnomer that you can't see anything in the city.
Okay.
Astronomy is alive and well in the city of Chicago.
Okay.
This event... bright enough, you can be anywhere. You can be in downtown Chicago on Michigan Avenue, and you'll see the eclipse.
Great.
I'll be in my garage roof by the way.
All right, there we go. I knew you were going to be in our roof. How did I have
She's going to start knocking at the door. I'm here, Joe. Let me in. Do you have any events coming up you want to let people know about?
Oh, we have a busy schedule with the Chicago Astronomer. We'll be in parks throughout the city. We are now become the astronomer for Evanston Township. And just look us up, Chicago Astronomer. All roads lead to me.
Oh, okay, Joe, we appreciate it.
Thank you so much for keeping us informed.
For more information, just head to chicagoastronomer.com. You can also find him on the socials. And we'll all be up in the middle of the night.
Excellent.
With you.